Welcome to Kusum.net. This is ASP.net MVC tutorial and you are watching part 102 called Partialview in MVC. So let's in this session what we will learn. We will learn how to create Partialview, how to write calling function at view side, how to send Partialview content from controller side to the view side. So let's look that. Before watching this video, please watch my part 101 autocomplete text box in MVC. So let's flip to the Visual Studio and check it now. So I have created this web application. I have this home controller and index method of that controller side. I will create one new page for calling Partialview. So right click on that index, click on add view. Use layout, right? So I have created this index view. Now I want one table, okay, to display the data. So that I have this database, and inside of this database there is one table of city, okay. I want to display the data of this table in the view page, right? So I need data entity model, and I have already created it inside of this model folder. Okay, this is my entity data model for city table. Okay, so this already I have created because of time consuming. First, I will create a partial view to call in the view page. Okay, so we will create it in shared folder so that we can use it in any place or any view. So right click on share folder, add view, and now create partial view, give it the name city partial, right? So city partial. Now in this city partial, I will create the table for city and call that in that view. Okay, so this city partial have also one display table. Okay, so using model address model web application one, but I have to display list of partial tables. So list web application one. Dot models dot city, right? This, let's now create div, and inside of that div we'll create one table. Table have this t-head. Inside of t-head tr, inside of tr there is th, right? This th, okay, here we will use city id. And here city name, okay. Now there is t body. Inside of t body tr and td, okay. Td have some values, but before that we will use enter it if model dot count is greater than 0, if model content is greater than 0, then we will display it in for each loop. So for each variable item in model okay, variable item in model, what this one t body. Okay, so this and copy this and this we will use here at the rate item. So item dot ctid and using item object called city name, right? So this table is ready now, but we want to display in the view page. Use this is the partial view and I want to call it inside of the view page. Okay, now this is my home controller, and to pass that partial view to the view side we have to write one method. Okay, so use http get so we can get the partial view, and write method public action result and name get partial view, right? You can give any name, no problem. This get partial view we will initialize. Okay, this my model have this entity, okay, employee db entities, and using that I have created this db object and will use in this partial view. Okay, now first I will initialize here the table of that partial view, city table. Okay, so list of city, list of city, city equal to new list of city, right? And city equal to use db object db dot cities dot to list, right? Or you can use order by db dot cities dot order by x such that x dot ctid. Okay, dot to list, right? And return partial view here, name of the partial view and you are using city, so city object, and name of the partial is what, city partial. So add city partial. Okay, now this index view page have nothing. Okay, and I want to call here that partial view, right? So this is the main thing here. I will write one function to fetch the partial view and display inside of the div tag. First I will create the place where we want to display the partial view. So division id equal to suppose div partial, right? This place I want to call that partial view, and here I will use that reserve keyword for partial view at html dot partial view at html dot partial name of the partial city partial and comma model, right? Because that partial view is used model. So let's finish this. This is only the place where we will call that partial view, right? Now we will write one function to load the partial view. Okay, so that I need one script okay, and here dollar document dot ready function, this load partial and document dot ready, and write the function, give the name load partial. Because of time less, I will copy this method here, right? Dollar dot AJAX. So let's copy from here. I have already done here. Dollar dot AJAX. Right. So I have used type get data type HTML, catch false, URL will be this method name. What is the method name? Get partial view. So inside of this URL, I will use that controller method name. Okay, and home is the controller name, and in the success function, using response, I will call this, where I want to call this name due partial. So copy this name, paste it here. Copy this name, paste it here. Dot load and dot HTML. Using this, I will load here the partial view. We have this error because we have not passed the model on the top of the view. So let's pass the model. Add the model and list of that web application one dot models dot city table. So city, and here we will write list. Right. Now you can see here the error is removed. Okay, save it and let's run it. Check it. I have added this partial view method here so that this partial view will call at the runtime of this index method. Okay, in the index search. Now just run the program. Right, you can see here in the view page of the index, I have called that partial view. Okay, calling partial view to the another view in the page. For that, what I have used this method and call it in the index view. And inside of that index view page, how I have called, I have used this function load partial, and one place I have Mac where the partial view is called, this place that table will be displayed. Okay, partial view table will be displayed here, this due partial, and that partial view first I have created in the inside of the share folder, this using model. Okay, so this is the end of my program. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe this channel. Share it, like it. Thank you. Have a great day.